say, well, for the third time in the last 5 years, the Portland Pirates hockey team will have a new NHL partner. Last week, the American Hockey League team announced that it was ending its relationship with the Buffalo Sabres. And today, the team announced its new National Hockey League partner. News 8 Sports Director Travis Lee leads off our team coverage of the Pirates' new affiliation agreement. Travis?
Tracy, the Portland Pirates announced a 5-year affiliation agreement with the NHL's Phoenix Coyotes today. A partnership is important for minor league franchise like Portland because the Pirates players are the property of the NHL team. And they play in Portland and try and develop their game and earn a promotion to the big leagues in Phoenix. And the Pirates talked to 4 different NHL teams about partnering. But Pirates managing owner Brian Petrick said that Phoenix wanted to be here the most, and that made breaking off the deal with Buffalo work.
Rest assured, this group is going to give us a competitive product. If I wasn't sure that they were going to do that, we wouldn't have allowed Buffalo to do what they were allowed to do, which was to buy another franchise and become a member of our league. We had 3 years left in this deal. So I consider this move in the best interest of our fans and our business, and I feel confident that we're going to deliver on that.
Now, interestingly, 2 of the 4 teams that talked to the Pirates about partnering up with them were interested in having the Pirates change their team nickname and logo. Now, for more on Portland's new deal, we're joined by News 8's Steve Minich live from the Civic Center. Steve?
Well, Travis, as we just heard a few hours ago from inside the Civic Center here, it sounds like the Pirates ownership is very happy with this new affiliation. But what about the fans, or better yet, and we exclude the Boston Bruins from this equation, but does it really matter to the fans who the parent club is?
But for the most part, it doesn't really matter.
Mike Hoffman's a longtime season ticket holder. What does matter, he says, is good hockey.
I think the bottom line total is the feeling of knowing that when you're going to the game, we do have a very good chance of going to the Calder Cup.
But I think it's more about the brand that we've put behind it.
Pirates owner Brian Petrovic is the first to admit it's not the Coyotes that fans will follow. It's the Portland Pirates, and this team's success rests not with what's happening in Phoenix, but right here.
But I think at the end of the day, what's more important is the product that's put on the ice, the character of the player that's on the ice and in the community.
While the Pirates don't share the luxury of a regionally favored affiliate like the Sea Dogs do with the Red Sox and Red Claws with the Celtics.
It's kind of the icing on the cake as far as it goes.
Even the Sea Dogs general manager contends the bottom line is not the parent club, rather the product.
I'm not sure that the fan base has changed too much from when we were the Marlins to the Red Sox. You know, if you're playing good baseball, then the baseball fans will show up.
They're going to put a competitive product on the ice for our fans day one.
Phoenix follows the Pirates' 3 former affiliates, first Washington from 93 to 05, then Anaheim, and most recently Buffalo. But ask these fans, it's not the new place, rather the new players they're excited to hear about.
Good players play a good game and a winning game.
All right, so again, the Civic Center now home to the Phoenix Coyotes' top farm team. And some of the fans we talked to also said that they are very excited about the minimum five-year deal that the Coyotes signed with Portland. In Portland, Steve Minich, News 8.